Okay, I could present, it's not a problem.
Okay, Ștefan.
Okay. For the first, thank you, Mr. Ozunu. Thank you, Mr. Misra, for the invitation. And I'm glad to be here today to talk about the collaboration between academic institution, especially to the university, and the social economic agent, and why not with the local public administration. I think that collaboration could be made by involving the young researcher, especially the young researcher, in the complex project that can be lead to develop their research career. I will start with my opinion regarding of the DRR institution in role of the risk scenario reduction. And after, I will support my opinion with a very short PowerPoint presentation. And I would like to highlight three things. For the first, I think the university through the research centers or the research institutes should be part in the natural risk and natural disaster assessment process, and why not to be part in the decision making process. Researcher and the institution have knowledge. They have researchers who developed methodology for identifying and for assessing the natural risk and the natural hazard. The institution, the university, the research centers have the necessary techniques. They have the specific equipment to do the research. And based on that, they have all the advantage to be part in the decision making process. The second opinion, the young researchers need to work more closely with the local public administration and the socio-economic actors. And the last opinion, I say so, the local public authorities may take into account the research of the researchers. Why? Because the local public authorities are those who implemented it in the field the politics of natural hazard and natural risk. And they must take into account the result of the researchers, and they must put the result of the research on the first plan. I think this. As I say, in order to support the above mentioned. I prepared a short presentation based on the collaboration between researchers as representatives to the university and the decision makers, mainly the public authorities in Romania, the public authorities who manage the risk and the hazard and the natural risk. And I will share my presentation. It's a very short presentation. It's based on a case study who is published in the remote sensing journal. And my presentation is based on the lack of digital database in Romania as a disadvantage or advantage for conducting the natural risk studies. All of my presentation is focused on the need for collaboration between decision factors and training of young researchers. This research, this case study, we will present, is realized as is implemented by a young team of researchers from the Faculty of Geography of Babeș-Bolyai University. Together of this team, I want to undertake a post-event research who take in account the risk associated with the flood produced in the Târlișua event. It's a big flood event in Romania. We want to undertake this research because we don't find any spatial database who show us the impact in the territory. We find only the numerical database, number of victims, number of buildings affected, but we don't find any spatial database to highlight the impact of the maximum flood. The entire research approach is based on the GIS spatial analysis models, and based on this GIS spatial analysis model, we want to manage the database from that flood. And for this, we need the maximum discharge, and DSM is the main database we use in our research. And in Romania, the public administration own the spatial database and manage the spatial database regarding to the natural hazard and natural risk. We went to local administration, to local public administration, and we asked for this database. And you have a great big surprise. They don't have such database to give us to make the research. And they told us they don't have a database because the analysis, the study area is a small catchment. This small catchment don't have a hydrometric station, and they don't measure the maximum discharge. And they put us, they give us DSM at 25 meter resolution. It's not a good database for our research, and we don't take in account the database, the spatial database, and we propose to reconstruct the maximum flow for our research and to make TSM-based photogrammetry techniques. These two databases help us to realize our research. We go in the field together with a small part of our team, mainly the young researchers, and take the database necessary to perform the photogrammetry techniques. So we take with us RTK GPS, Phantom 4 drone, and we make all the steps necessary for the photogrammetry techniques. We measure 23 points, 80 points was used for GCP and 5 points as control points. Based on software and Phantom 4 drone, we make 12 flight with a double grid mission and with overlapping at 85%. Based on the Agisoft software, we obtain a DSM with 4.63, I think, centimeter resolution. The digital model who is good for our work. We have the digital DSM, the digital elevation model, digital surface model. We could calculate the discharge in hydrometrical profiles in our catchment. We obtain based on the Manning equation the maximum discharge for that event. We were ready through our research. We create two digital databases who could give to the public administration and all the researchers who need this database. Based on the maximum discharge DSM, we created a hydraulic model and we obtained three main databases for our project: the speed of the water and the shear stress, and the main database obtained is the depth of the water in the catchment in our area. We have that database, we obtain a hazard map and based on the building as exposure to the risk, we create a hazard map and a hazard risk map with the buildings, the consequences quantified in Euroloc. And considering that not information on hazard risk is available in the field, we create a GIS portal who take in account the hazard map and the risk assessment map. This portal is free and all the actors can obtain the information based on this portal. This portal is another way to collaboration between researchers and local public administration. The researchers provide the information, provide this portal, and the public administration could manage this portal for informating the people and the human component of the risk. Here you have the entire workflow for our research. And in conclusion, I say that the lack of spatial database is a disadvantage only based on the long time to carry out the proposed research. But the lack of the spatial database is mainly an advantage. Because the need to develop the complex research models, the young researcher developed the skills through participation in the complex teams of research, and the participation in the complex teams lead to continuous training of the researcher and could familiarize the researchers with the management of the spatial database and their integration in the complex spatial analysis model. And not the last, the lack of database leave the possibility to attract the project from the local public administration. The researcher offer the product, the final product, and the public administration use this product for information and for decision making. I think the young researchers need to access projects in order to disseminate his research. Most publication require the publication fees for article, and these fees cannot be support from the research budget. The fees can be support from the research project with the socioeconomic actors and with the public administration. As I say, this research is published. I will put the link to this publication in chat area for those who is interested for this. And thank you again for the invitation. Thank you.